All right, this is Tuesday, July the 29th, 2014. It is 8:13 p.m. Now, the purpose of this video is for this. I'm going to give out a little bit of information regarding a problem we had when we moved into this house the end of May of this year. All right, I'm going to do some videos. But I'm just going to do a webcam video just to get it all out there first. All right, when we came to look at the house, this was back in February, I think it was March maybe, in around there. We, of course, came with our agent. And upon coming with our agent, who we thought was a decent human being, and was going to stand behind us no matter what, obviously lied and didn't seem to take an interest in doing the right things when asked. All right, our agent we had was, his name is Joe Enright, was Century 21. And we thought this guy was a pretty decent individual. When we came to look at this place, everything seemed okay. We asked about this, we asked about that. We asked about, there's no water. We asked about, flooding. There's none of that. We asked, has there been problems with this, problems with the roof? Now, it says about the roof being whatever. And we have shingle problems. No leaking, just the shingles themselves. So, again, that wasn't disclosed properly. Number two, our entire furnace needs to be replaced and the air conditioning needs to be replaced because neither work and haven't worked. And when we came to look at the house, we asked about that. And we were told, oh yeah, works great. But the agent, our agent, Joe Enright, you would have thought would have done some investigating into that because that's what they do. And when we asked for the disclosure, he just seemed to be, the whole thing seemed to be very hesitant on giving it. And he would take care of it. Okay, so you trust he's going to do this. To make a long story short, when we moved in, we tried to get the air conditioning going. And it was a dead issue. We were like, well, what the hell? We ended up playing with this, playing with that, had to look and come to find out that it does not work. Now here's the thing. Mr. Enright's buddy, it's his good buddy apparently, who is a somewhat retired real estate, so-called real estate attorney. His name is Kirk R Kirby. And he works out of some place in East St. Paul, Manitoba. And this guy is a little prick. We were told by this Kirk R. Kirby that we will get the disclosure. We'll find out what's going on with this. We never got it. We went back and forth with our agent. And after we moved into this place and we found out some of these things that were wrong, suddenly we could no longer get a hold of Mr. Enright or Mr. Kirby. Gee, they were suddenly gone. To make a long story short, if you guys remember that problem that we had with our alarm system, well, I mean, it wasn't our alarm system, it was the previous person. One night it went off because we were told by this Joe Enright, the Century 21 agent, that was disconnected. It no longer existed. So we're under the assumption that it will go off, right? There's nothing there. Well, that was a lie because that one night we went to open the basement windows to get things kind of cleaned up and the sucker went off. You guys heard it. We called this Joe Enright and said to him, you know, what's going on? Well, this day that we called him, he was just amazingly that day happened to be in the hospital getting some kind of elective surgery. And oh, he's all groggy. Oh, I can't this. I don't know what's going on. Then why are you answering your phone for business, numbnuts? I mean, does that make any sense whatsoever? So anyway, he says, well, we'll try getting a hold of this guy, that guy. No one would even give us the information as to who the other the other agent and or the other attorney was, it was like, oh, I don't know. Oh, we tried getting a hold of him. Oh, this person's playing golf and wherever. You're like, what the fuck? Get off your ass and get the information. You have to give it to us. Go get a subpoena and get the information. What is the problem? So anyway, we were told that things would be taken care of and that we're gonna get something out of this, because there's no way you can tell us that when the lady that had, I mean, she was an old codger, not really an old codger, but she was an older lady, and it seems from us and speaking to other neighbors, this person was basically a con artist. She fleeced a lot of companies. She owed hundreds of thousands of dollars. She had to leave this house because she had how many liens? And she had tons of unpaid bills to contractors, banks. I mean, she was basically, either you leave the house or you go to jail. That was basically the thing. The money she got out of the house was pretty much nothing. It all went to pay her bills. And when we were investigating this, I did some digging, I spoke to some people, and I found out some very good information about what I need to know to pursue things. Now, I always had a bad feeling about this Joe Enright and this Kirk R. Kirby. I didn't like them, especially this Kirk R. Kirby, this as he calls himself, somewhat semi-retired. I'm like, you're either retired or you're doing it. I mean, you can't do it on the side. And this guy was very, very evasive. He didn't want to answer questions. You know, and I basically said to him, don't fuck me. I said, don't fuck me. If you fuck me, I'm going to fuck you, you know. And it got pretty, it kind of got a little stupid. But this Kirk R. Kirby, he's a little weasel. You ask the guy questions and he doesn't know. And he says he'll find out, and then he says he forgot, that kind of thing. And it was like, listen, buddy, you know what? I think it's best, and that's where I'm going to go with this. Pardon me, right now I'm going to go with a buyer beware, a fraud watch. For any of you out there in Winnipeg, or it's a residential or a business or whatever, for any of you out there that are looking to do any type of business to get involved with Century 21 Real Estate, with an agent by the name of Joseph Enright, please stay away. He'll do what he can to screw you, and then in the end, tries to run away. He doesn't want to answer questions. And from what I've read and understood, this is not the first time. He uses his good buddy, Kirk R. Kirby. And this guy, like I said, supposedly runs his business somewhere in East St. Paul. 2200 something East St. Paul is where he's got his office or whatever, I don't know. And this dude doesn't know anything. All right. I kind of knew the guy was a bit of a very quirky kind of individual. The first day we met him to sign some papers. He has a pen. This is obviously not the pen, but because I'm sure he would be going through meltdown mode if it was. He has his own pen that he, and it's only his. No one else can touch it. So we were signing some papers, and I went to take his pen. He goes, oh, no, not that pen, please. I can't let anybody use that pen. I'm like, holy shit. I was like, calm down there, George. Like, holy fuck, did you use that pen there? It's a pen. The guy went just crazy because someone went to touch his pen. So right there was my first instinct that the guy was a little, something's not up and up with this dude. The business end of it, he just seems very shifty. There's something not right, again, trying to say, you know, that he can't contact this person. Here's what essentially was. The air conditioner and the air conditioning unit is totally finished. The furnace system is kaput. It never worked. And someone's going to try to use a wall. It worked when I was here. No, it did not. Because we asked for the disclosure and we didn't get it. And that's where we're wondering, oh, well, we'll get it. It's coming. Well, obviously now, when we were here, the place was being heated by the oven. Okay? This woman that was showing the place, when we came with this Joe Enright, he talks about that he knows everything and he knows this and he's been doing this for 30 years and he's Mr. Know-It-All. Well, if he knew all of this, why did he not know to ask the questions that he knows he's supposed to ask? This shouldn't have happened. That's what made us believe that somebody was getting a cutback or could have been getting a cutback somewhere, saying, oh, gee, well, we'll do this and then we'll share the money and you have your surgery, I go golfing. It all went together. And we've given that scenario to a number of people at it, and they say, very plausible, and asking me, how did you ever find this out? How did you ever think about that? I said, think that it all goes together. This happens, and then a few weeks later, boom, makes sense. Then this individual, and then all of a sudden when we told this guy, all of a sudden he shows up one day with a motor for a furnace. How would you know to bring something like that, and how would you just amazingly have something like that hanging around? We believe that they both knew something was up. And knowing this, the money that's being put into that, I'm not going to get into anything else, as I will not divulge any of that certain information, not because of those people, for my own reasons. And what I will tell you is that this Kirk R. Kirby, he could have easily have countered offered and said, okay, well, how about we do this and we make a deal for something? He just basically said, oh, sorry, I can't do nothing. What he did essentially was this. I believe he got paid. I believe he got a payoff of some sort, because it's very, very, it seems quite, I'm not saying he did, but I'm saying it seemed very much like it went. He was working with somebody to do that. And that's what I am currently having investigated. I've had some of his, I'm not going to say who, I can't say who, but I've got some people looking on the books, let's put it that way. Whatever way that needs to be done is being done. Whatever can be done is being done. Anyway, just to reiterate here, for those of you in Winnipeg who are looking to do business, sell your house, buy a house, whatever, do not and stay away. Buyer beware, stay away. If you do not want to get screwed over, if you want to lose money and you want to get screwed and all this good shit, if you want that, then you go see Joseph Enright with Century 21. Do it right with Joe Enright. Or if you want it done right, phone Jeanette, Joe Enright. No, if you want to get fucked, call Joe Enright. That's really what it is. And he knows how I feel, and he won't talk to me. He doesn't like talking because he thinks he doesn't want to hear that from me. Well, how would you like to hear this? You want to hear a gavel come down? Anyway, I'm going to do some videos regarding this, and I'm going to keep everybody up to date. I'm doing this because I feel that we were screwed over, but we weren't, because these two individuals got caught, and they got caught pretty quick. They did not think that I would put two and two together. The reason I've waited this long is because, like I said, I've had to wait for the information to come back to me. It's been a while, but now I can finally do this. And we will make sure that those involved get their just desserts, and it will not be forgotten. This will never be forgotten. So like I said, please, to keep your sanity and to keep yourself safe, monetarily and in your mind, you stay away from Century 21, and if you do, you stay away from Joseph Enright, and you stay away from anybody by the name of Kirk R. Kirby. His business practices are very shady, and he's up to no good, and the guy is full of crap. I mean, the other agent said jump, he just said how high. Seems like he was working with somebody, to split some cash somewhere. Anyway, that's that. I will do some videos in a bit, and I'll keep y'all up to date, and that be that.